Parents, do your students use the Twitch app or watch Twitch videos? Well, what is Twitch? Well, in this app guide, we are going to show you exactly what this phenomenon is, who owns it, and whether you should let your kids use it or not. Now, first, Twitch marketing says, "We are a global community of millions who come together each day to create their own entertainment, unique, live, unpredictable, never-to-be-repeated experiences created by the magical interactions of the many." With chat built into every stream, you don't just watch on Twitch, you're a part of the show. Now, Twitch marketing says choose popular games, watch gamers, chat, or join live chat. This is where it gets a little bit of a problem. Follow your favorites and explore live channels. Now, what is Twitch? Well, Twitch is a live streaming video platform owned by Amazon. The platform is predominantly used to live stream users playing video games. Some popular video formats are esports, tournaments, personal streams of individual players, and gaming-related talk shows. Now, streamers will live stream a video with commentary, and users can chat along with the video live, or users can choose to be invisible while watching the video. Videos can be watched live, or users can watch a replay of the missed live stream. Streamers, who are those that broadcast live videos, can earn commissions on games they advertise during their videos. And this is how they build revenue, and this is kind of where things are going. Users can follow their favorite streamers for free or subscribe to their channel for a fee. Additionally, users can purchase games through the Twitch platform. We'll talk about that in a minute. Now, just a quick note. We have a free guide where I want to teach your kids how to have a plan. I want them to have fun online, but I have a free guide called How to Navigate Social Media with Your Student. You can visit, click the link below, or visit smartsocial.com newsletter. It's 100% free, and it'll teach you how to audit or monitor your kids online in a positive way to see what they're doing, activities that you can do offline in a dialogue to set a message and create a game plan, and then how to take positive group photos and share them on social media to shine online. You know that I wrote a bunch of books called Light, Bright, and Polite. And this is really our free guide to just get you started. It's super easy. I know that you're going to love it. Go take a peek at it. Now, what is Twitch? Well, Twitch is a library of emoticons available for users called emotes. Some emotes are free for all users, but users can buy subscriptions to access more. The cheering feature allows users to cheer for their favorite live streamers for a small fee. In order to use the cheering feature, a user must pay with bits. Bits are a form of currency on Twitch, which is bought using real money on Amazon. Streamers can earn badges on their channels depending on how many cheers they've received. Now, non-game related content can also be live streamed on Twitch. Some other categories of content include music, creative, and IRL, which stands for in real life. Music content can be radio shows, music productions, activities, or live shows. Creative content showcases the process of completing an artistic or creative piece of work. In real life content is for any video that really doesn't fit into the other main categories. And video games with an adult only rating are not allowed on Twitch. Now, Twitch is available on a desktop, Amazon Fire TV, Roku, Chromecast, Xbox, PlayStation, iOS, and really just about anywhere, Android devices. Users must be 13 years or older to sign up for Twitch, but we recommend the parents really supervise their children, no matter whether they're 0 to 18 years old. No matter when you let your kids online, we want to make sure you're there with them. Now, as of May 2018, Twitch had 2.2 million broadcasters monthly and 15 million daily active users. So this isn't just a little tiny game, and it's backed by one of the world's biggest and richest people, Amazon.com. Users spend an average of 2 hours a day on the platform, and one of the top 20 most trafficked websites in the US is Twitch. So here's some top streamers. Look, 13 million followers, 5 million followers, 4 million, and so on. And there are Ninja, Shroud, Summit 1G, Riot Games, and then we've got the Tatman, all these Dr. Disrespect, and all these other things. Okay, now why should parents care? Well, Twitch is the leading live streaming video service for video games in the US, meaning it's very popular with students. I've even seen some celebs go, "We're gonna go over to Twitch and we're gonna play games," and you have to actually, to participate or do stuff, you're paying them a dollar or something, and the celebrity's making quite a bit of money. Live chat rooms are a main feature of the platform, which can be dangerous for tweens and teens. Users can receive private messages called whispers. Why should parents care? Well, students could come across inappropriate content either through graphic video games, mature language, or advertisements. It's everywhere. I was on Instagram today showing somebody something, and something very inappropriate popped up. Even though I'm not even following anybody inappropriate, content just ends up on there. I don't know how. I mean, I do, but you have to understand that bad content is everywhere in every app. Users are constantly being encouraged to make purchases on Twitch, so costs can add up if parents aren't monitoring and setting guidelines. No matter how much you configure your student's Twitch security settings, there is no way to know if the content really is safe for your student unless you become familiar with the platform and review their favorite videos or streamers, the people that broadcast, and that's why you got to be where your kids are at. Now, here's what the news says. NetNanny says it pretty much becomes a yelling contest filled with cyberbullying, hate speech, and more. And Internet Safe Education says, with Twitch's popularity, the platform has now attracted similar predators, some predators. Now, here's some other popular games on Twitch. Fortnite, League of Legends, you've hopefully watched our Fortnite app guide. Dota 2, PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, similar to Fortnite. Hearthstone, Overwatch, Counter-Strike, Global Offense. Now, what parents say about Twitch, I'm just going to keep it short. This questionable platform should be monitored if you do not want your child to be viewing this type of suggested content. Twitch is for the most part a teen to adult website, says another mom. Here's what another parent says. Women streamers using their bodies and over-sexualizing their stream to gain more viewers and in turn donors or people that are paying. This should obviously raise a red flag for parents. Now, what can parents do? Well, talk to your student and ask them if they have a Twitch account or if their friends use the platform. If your student has an account, we recommend that they delete it and focus on apps that can have a positive impact on their digital footprint. And my free download, my free guide, really gets you started there. If you decide Twitch is safe for your student because you're there with them, well, be on the platform with them as much as you can to monitor their activity, configure their account settings to limit who they can talk to, and block private messages from strangers. Remind your children to never share personal information with anyone on Twitch. Now, know what games that your students are playing, and also watch their videos to determine if they're safe for your family. Always consider talking with your kids about screen time guidelines. Explain to them that your student, you're really just protecting your student. And in our guide and some of my other micro videos, I really talk about setting a goal with your kids, not just making it so that you are telling your kids what to do, but rather, do you think it's right that we have these guidelines? What do you think is fair? Really sit down and work with your kids. The best way to upset them is to say, hey, here's the new rules. I mean, that might be right in certain instances, you get it. But if it's a long term and your kid is pretty good, but they're just a little addicted, that's just something to consider. Now, create a supportive environment by telling your children that they can always come to you or a trusted adult, and this is key, if they come across content that makes them uncomfortable on Twitch. Another thing to consider too is if they won't listen to you at all, consider going to that cool uncle or cool aunt that's a trusted adult that you trust and have a talk with them about talking with your kids. It really does take a whole village. And also, teach your children to keep their content light, bright, and polite on the platform because it can show up in their digital footprint. You know that I got a bunch of books out called Light, Bright, and Polite. This is the latest one. You can go pick it up by going to smartsocial.com and rolling over the top and you know, clicking on favorite books, or go to Google Light, Bright, and Polite on Amazon, wherever books are sold. My next steps for you are go search for yourself on Google and your kids. Go audit and monitor. My free guide is going to show you that. Use your Instagram as a portfolio. Also, I've got a great conference coming up called the Smart Social Week Conference that really deep dives. I mean, our free guide gives you a taste test, and then it's going to deep dive with over 70 powerful people speaking on 15 panel discussions that you can download on your phone and watch from the convenience of your house. And then take more positive group photos and really show your students how to share them on the new site, on their new website, or their social media stuff. As schools, you can request 500 passes to our new program. Our new program is where I actually work with your school and we develop a messaging thing for your all your students. Step one is let's develop the message that you want colleges to see and what is that career that you want. Step two is how do we make your Instagram positive using that message? And step three is how do we build a website when you're ready in high school that it shows all these awesome, authentic things that you're doing? And we talk a lot about that in the conference, an online parent-teacher conference tackling screen time addiction, social media safety, and positive online behavior. Every parent and educator learns how to monitor your children each week using our proprietary tool called Footprint Friday, activities to get your kids off their screens, addiction is huge right here, and then last, how to get your kids focused on their future, which is so important without keeping them out of trouble. So, so important, guys. Hey, if you're an educator and you want to learn more about us, I want to show you exactly how to do that. You go to smartsocial.com, you take a look at it, and there's a Hire Us button up at the top. You can set up a call with us on the Hire Us button. You can also, on the Hire Us button, you can learn more about our online branding workshop that we take to schools with a three-step program. How do we plan? Students learned how to plan their future career goals and develop their message that they want colleges and employers to discover. Let's get your kids monitoring themselves. Step two is a social media positive training, a practical formula students use to have fun online and keep their Instagram account positive for colleges and future employers. And that's really crucial. So this is for every student. This is for students in middle school and high school. And this is really for students towards the end of middle school and all of high school. Hands-on training to build a digital portfolio website that helps students share their projects and accomplishments to get discovered on Google by colleges. Schools, if you're watching, you gotta know that this helps reduce the negative impact of a student's social media post that could hurt your community. It establishes a roadmap for your student's social media education. It creates a positive digital culture on campus that promotes healthy screen time habits. So important. You'll learn how to teach students to use social media in a positive way. That's what I believe in. And I really think you can kill the world with kindness in a really good way. And they will come back going, wow, I want to learn more about this student. Turn your students into positive examples. Reduce stress on parents by creating a plan that protects each family at home and at school. You can learn more about this, see what people are saying, and we have an amazing little program that you could bring to your school. Wow, have I talked about a lot? But I'm really thankful that you would watch this, that you would consider at least taking the next step to make sure that your students are protected. I'm Josh Ochs. At least also take our free guides, download that guide, click the link below for the newsletter. By joining our newsletter, you get instant access to that. You can also go buy any one of our books, Light, Bright, and Polite. We've got a bunch of them. We have ones for your staff, and we even have ones, a green one for the parents. It's pretty awesome. But this really teaches you that you can have a resume of positivity that shows a school past performance is a predictor of future behavior, and let's start using or showing students that this device, it needs to be used with a purpose instead of just a pastime. And that is really what's gonna help fix the culture on your campus. It's not telling kids what not to do, but rather instead, it's gonna be, look, you said that you wanna be an astronaut, a physicist, whatever, a firefighter. What do you think that organization wants to see on here? Let's forget about colleges for a sec. Let's talk about careers. Now let's backtrack to colleges. Now let's backtrack to what does your Instagram need to look like to get you there? And then how do we develop a website? I'm excited, and I'm thankful that you watched this video. I'll see you soon. I'm Josh Ochs from smartsocial.com. I hope to see you on our next podcast. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. Please give us a thumbs up on this video on YouTube. Please rate, review, and subscribe so that we can reach you with all of our safety guides from all over the world. Thank you to the million people a year that visit our website and the tens of thousands of people in our newsletter. I'll see you guys soon. I'm Josh Ochs. Have a great day.